It's the question political insiders are asking. What's going on inside Mark Newman's campaign for governor? Today on Upfront, I'll ask a Republican power broker who first backed Newman, but has now switched his support to Scott Walker. Will Wisconsin become the next state to approve marijuana for medicinal use? This Sunday, two lawmakers debate the idea that would allow pot to patients. And state lawmakers are poised to pass tougher new penalties on drunken drivers. Today, Upfront asks a couple who lost their daughter and granddaughter in a horrific crash, is this bill enough? It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gousha.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. We begin today with the debate over medical marijuana. This week, lawmakers will hold a hearing that could help put Wisconsin on the path to becoming the next state to allow pot for patients. Some people who suffer from serious illnesses like cancer, Crohn's disease, or AIDS say smoking marijuana helps them. It controls their pain or lessens their nausea. A bill recently introduced in the state legislature would legalize marijuana for medicinal uses. To date, states that have legalized marijuana as medicine include our Midwestern neighbor, Michigan. There are 13 in all. But critics say more medical research needs to be done before this bill is passed. We're joined now by two state senators on opposite sides of this issue. John Erpenbach, the Democrat from Wanakee, is the bill's sponsor in the Senate. Ted Cannabis, the Republican from Brookfield, tells us he won't vote for it. Thanks to both of you for being with us today.
He won't vote for it today.
Today. You're going to convince him.
Yeah, we have a long way to go on this.
Well, we'll give you a couple of minutes. Why don't we begin by having you briefly make the case for why you think this is needed in our state?
Well, I've talked to enough people around the state who have never broken the law ever, never used a drug, never smoked a cigarette, and are dealing with cancer or are dealing with AIDS. And they know that, especially in cancer, with the chemo treatments being extremely harsh on the system, and the drugs for the pain management that's prescribed by the doctors are very harsh on their system. So what they do is they send out a family member, they go out and buy pot, and they smoke it or they cook it into a brownie or something like that. Not only does it help them create an appetite, it also helps them keep food down. And keeping your weight on, especially during chemo, is extremely important. So I think we are not in a position to say to someone, no, sorry, you can't have that. I think that's the wrong way to go.
So you say this is about compassion. What is your concern about this?
The biggest problem that I have with this bill, Mike, is that the science obviously doesn't add up. I mean, when you take a look at marijuana as a device, the FDA doesn't approve of smoking any kind of drug because you can't control any of the dosage. Also, marijuana obviously is a drug of abuse. It's one that, you know, creates dependencies, and there are some really long-term problems that can come from it. If you smoke 5 joints a week, it's like smoking a pack of cigarettes a day. If you're going to go through a process where you say, hey, government, you have to validate that this is a very solid way to have pain management, which is a huge issue for a lot of people, we better make sure the science is there.
The argument that he's making is endorsed, in fact, by the Wisconsin Medical Society, which says, you know, we still have some concerns about this, about the health consequences, about dosage, purity, issues like that. Mm-hmm. What do you say to those kinds of comments?
Well, first of all, it doesn't have to be smoked. And if you're going to smoke it, you can get a vaporizer and remove all the toxins from it. That's one thing you can do. And obviously, you can cook it into something or you can just eat it. So there's several different ways to get it into your system. Obviously, the studies haven't been there because the FDA won't take a look at this, in part, I think, because the pharmaceutical companies do not want this to happen. They don't. They can make Marinol, which is a synthetic THC, which for some people is not good for their system at all. Not good for their system at all. So again, it's a situation where 13 other states have done this. I think it's a documented fact. If you talk to people who use it for medicinal purposes only, if you're talking to an MS patient and they have less spasms when they use marijuana as opposed to their regular medication, I think we need to listen to that.
How restrictive would this law be? Because there are medical marijuana laws and there are medical marijuana laws. There's California, where they say in the city of Los Angeles there are more places that dispense medical marijuana than there are Starbucks.
Right.
And then there's Michigan, which has a narrower a reading of the law. What kind of law would we see in the state of Wisconsin?
It's going to be extremely narrow as to where places that can actually dispense it.
And what kind of uses it could
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Right now we have a list in the legislation of a couple of different diseases that will qualify already, and the Department of Health and Family Services may add to that list in the rulemaking process. But it's going to be very narrow. It's not a situation where if you have a cold, for example, in California, you might qualify for medical marijuana. That's not going to be the case here in this state.
How about chronic back pain, something like that? today?
I don't know. I think it's something the Department of Health and Family Services will take a look at. Maybe, maybe not. But I this is more so for real heavy-duty diseases like cancer, like AIDS.
What's wrong with a narrowly crafted piece of legislation that says only for this, this, and this?
Well, I think what's interesting is the way the bill is crafted. And let's take a look at what it says. It says that we're going to have, in Wisconsin, nonprofits put together something called compassion centers, which will be in different places in Wisconsin. But the bill also says that those compassion centers can't be within 500 feet of a school. Why is that? Because compassion centers are handing out a drug that the federal government has said is illegal and dangerous. We have to be very careful if we're going to go down this road. And that's the problem I have with government being in the marijuana business, is that suddenly we're not only validating that this is something that is should be legal effectively, but we're also saying effectively to everybody, marijuana is okay, because it's a drug that's used for treating something as easy to treat as like back pain or something like that. This is a very dangerous, it is a slippery slope, because when the government opens the door, the government can always expand usage.
Take a look at what the government's opened the door for already, morphine. And things that are much worse. And they said it's okay as long as the doctor prescribes it. It's okay. Marijuana is not even close to what morphine is. Not even close. And so it's a situation where, again, the drugs that are being prescribed in a cancer case, for example, you know, they get together, they figure out, okay, we're going to take these pills and you're going to take these pills to counter these pills. And if you're dealing with someone who's going through chemotherapy, if they have the choice of ingesting marijuana one way or another and getting it into their system, or take all these pills that have all these side effects, they're going to want to use marijuana. And again, it's a situation where we've spent a lot of resources federally and in the state on DARE programs and stuff like that, saying drugs are bad. But in some cases, drugs are okay. And in some cases, when you're dealing with these diseases, I think marijuana is just fine. It's not a slippery slope in these situations.
Yeah, sure.
It's a situation where somebody doesn't want to get cancer so they can smoke pot. That's not what we're dealing with. They've already got the disease.
No.
Go ahead.
Well, listen, pain management is something that's very important for all people that have diseases, and, you know, we take it very seriously. And John's argument, I think, is specious on that point. You know, the idea that, you know, we're not concerned about people having options for pain management is ridiculous. This is about making policy that's going to be able to have a culture in Wisconsin that fits our values, okay? And what I think is important for us to talk about is how we can take this bill that John's going to put forward and have a reasoned discussion about, are we sure that we want to validate that marijuana is fine? He said that it's not a gateway drug. That's not true. It is a gateway drug.
I've got about 45 seconds left.
As far as our values are concerned, if you take a look at any single poll, even recently a TV station in Milwaukee did a poll, 92% of the people who responded support this.
Oh, well, 92% of the people responded said they were in favor of your health care bill, too.
At well over 70 to 75% in any poll statewide, people support this.
Well, then that's the final question. This has been tried in the past. It hasn't gotten very far. Could it happen this time? I mean, you saw what happened in Michigan.
Sure.
63% of the people approved it in a referendum.
Sure.
It was approved by a majority in every county in the state.
I think when people find out what this bill does and have a real understanding of the implications, not only short-term but long-term, I don't believe the bill will pass.
Senator Ted Cannabis from Brookfield, Senator John Erpenbach from Wanakee.
Thanks very much to both of you for being with us.
Coming up next on Upfront, new penalties are coming for drunken drivers in Wisconsin. I'll ask a family who pushed the new law if it's tough enough. And inside Mark Newman's campaign for governor, why did a prominent Republican backer leave? His answer when Upfront continues.
Upfront with Mike Gousha, brought to you by American Transmission Company and the Wisconsin Corn Growers Association.